Greetings from Dave and Cindy Nyhoff on this Memorial Day weekend. We're going to share a devotional with you. Dave's going to read the scripture and I'm going to read the devotional.
This is John 5, 1 through 15. Sometime later, Jesus went up to Jerusalem for a feast of the Jews. Now there is in Jerusalem near the Sheep Gate a pool, which in Aramaic is called Bethesda, and which is surrounded by five covered colonnades. Here a great number of disabled people used to lie, the blind, the lame, the paralyzed. One who was there had been an invalid for 38 years. When Jesus saw him there and learned that he had been in this condition for a long time, he asked him, "Do you want to get well?" "Sir," the invalid replied, "I have no one to help me into the pool when the water is stirred. While I am trying to get in, someone else goes down ahead of me." Then Jesus said to him, "Get up, pick up your mat and walk." At once the man was cured. He picked up his mat and walked. The day on which this took place was a Sabbath, and so the Jews said to the man who had been healed, "It is the Sabbath. The law forbids you to carry your mat." But he replied, "The man who made me well said to me, 'Pick up your mat and walk.'" So they asked him, "Who is this fellow who told you to pick it up and walk?" The man who was healed had no idea who it was, for Jesus had slipped away into the crowd that was there. Later, Jesus found him at the temple and said to him, "See, you are well again. Stop sinning, or something worse may happen to you." The man went away and told the Jews that it was Jesus who had made him well.
Many years ago, I received a Rubbermaid spatula as a bridal shower gift. After 38 years of use, it's in rather rough shape. The handle is warped where it was set on a hot stove burner, and the tip is gouged from a time I used it to scrape the sides of the blender while the blender was running. I have a drawer full of new spatulas, but I keep reaching for the old battered one when I need to stir something. It isn't superior in any way. I've just gotten very used to it, and I can't seem to part with it. 38 years is also the amount of time the invalid man in John 5 had been laying by the healing pool. When the waters were stirred by an angel of the Lord, who probably didn't use a spatula, no one helped the man get into the water. He'd lost hope of ever being healed and had lost the desire to even try to get to the pool. He had gotten very used to his way of life and he couldn't seem to part with it. In Luke 17, Jesus heals 10 lepers. Readers of this passage are stunned that only one of them remembered to thank Jesus for healing. But we have no indication that the man healed by the pool of Bethesda thanked Jesus. When the Jewish leaders, who recognized him as the longtime invalid, asked him who had healed him, he didn't even know. And when he encountered Jesus again, he still showed no gratitude, but rather reported Jesus to the Jewish leaders. The man had been waiting for healing so long, he forgot he was waiting. Jesus urged him to live differently and to stay away from the sin of unbelief that had kept him out of the pool all those years. Being physically afflicted is unpleasant, but being paralyzed by our sinful ways of life is even worse, especially after we've encountered Jesus. Pray with me. God, we need your healing touch. Keep us from making excuses. Help us not to wait another moment to receive all that you have for us. Send the Holy Spirit to stir our hearts and draw us away from sin and into a life of belief and gratitude. Amen. Have a wonderful Memorial Day weekend. Hope to see you at the Foundry soon.